Hi, I'm Julian Lovelock, Product Manager for Amazon Verified Permissions. Our service enables you to implement permissions management and authorization within the applications that you build. Today, I'll be demonstrating a new feature that makes it simple for you to use Amazon Cognito and Verified Permissions to authenticate and authorize user access to APIs hosted on Amazon API Gateway. We're going to take a look at how your application can use an access token minted by Amazon Cognito and present it to API Gateway to authorize that user to call an API. API Gateway will send the token to Amazon Verified Permissions to get a decision based on a set of CEDAR policies and then enforce that decision by either allowing or denying the user access to the API. Now, at this point, you may be thinking, that looks great in theory, but how do I do this in practice? I don't know how to write CEDAR policies or code a Lambda authorizer to make calls to Verified Permissions. Well, the good news is that you can now set up this entire flow without writing a single line of code. This video will show you how to do that. We'll be using the Quick Start Wizard to create a policy store with role-based access control policies expressed in CEDAR for your APIs, and then deploy a Lambda authorizer to call that policy store. I already have a Cognito user pool that I set up called Pet Store Users. And in this user pool, we have two groups set up, the customer group and the employee group. And I have two users set up, Abby, who is in the customer group, and Julian, who is in the employee group. I'm going to show how we can create policies that will give access to APIs based on this group membership. First, let's create a new API hosted on API Gateway. So I'm in API Gateway. I'm going to click on Create API. We're going to create a REST API, and we're going to do that by importing an off-the-shelf one. And the example API we're going to choose is going to be our friend, the Pet Store application. So I scroll down and click on Create API. You can see this sample API has four APIs, a GET at the level of the application, a GET pets, and a POST pets. And then a GET for a specific pet ID. And none of these APIs currently have an authorization method set up. Lastly, we'll need to deploy our API. So we're going to deploy it to a new stage, and we'll call that stage Pet Store Dev. So now we want to connect our API gateway to Verified Permissions for authorization purposes. And as a quick refresher of what we're trying to achieve, we want to create a flow whereby a user can log into the application. The application authenticates that user using Amazon Cognito. Amazon Cognito issues an access token. And then the application passes that access token with an API access request to API Gateway. An API Gateway calls Verified Permissions, which validates the access request against a set of CEDAR policies to determine whether this user is permitted to call this API. And the way that's all going to work is through this Lambda authorizer, which is going to connect API Gateway to Verified Permissions. So the workflow we're going to go through now is to create that Lambda authorizer. We do that from within Verified Permissions. So I'm now in the Verified Permissions console, and I'm going to click on Create Policy Store. And you'll see a new option here to set up with Cognito and API Gateway. So that's the approach I'm going to take. Select that, click on Next. So the first thing I do is to select the API that I want to protect. And of course, I'm going to pick my pet store. and the pet store dev deployment stage. And from here, I'll import the API. Now, if I scroll down, you can see the API comprises of these four calls: get at the application level, get pets, post pets, and get pets for a specific pet ID. And these four calls have been mapped across to four CEDA actions, which mirror the naming of the calls. And it's these actions that will be represented within the policies that we write to determine who is allowed to call these APIs. Click on Next, and I'm asked to select a Cognito user pool. And I only have one option, which is my pet store users, so I'll select that. Now, in this demo, we're going to use the access token as the method to validate the authorization request, but you could also choose to validate the authorization request based on the identity token created by Cognito. And we're going to stick with the default to not validate the client IDs. This is where the magic happens. This is where we create our CEDA policies that determine who is allowed to call which APIs. And if you remember, within the Cognito user pool, we set up two groups, customers and employees. So these groups are imported automatically from the pool, and we're given the opportunity to create policies for each of these groups. So firstly, I'm going to create a policy for the employees group, and I'm going to allow users in the employees group, such as Julian, to call all of the APIs. So I'll select all of the actions, the four actions that we created in the schema. Now, users in the customers group, for the purpose of this demo, I'm going to limit them to calling only the Get Pets API. I click on Next. And that's the setup complete. It really is as simple as that. Now, when I go ahead and create the policy store, we'll create the policy store, which is the container into which these policies are placed. We create the identity source, which is the connector back to Cognito. We create a schema, which reflects the entity types, and we'll take a look at that in a second. And we'll create two policies, a policy defining permissions for the customer group, and a policy defining permissions for the employee group. And then we'll create a Lambda authorizer, which will be deployed through CloudFormation to our API gateway. And then we're going to need to go across into API gateway and manually connect or attach that authorizer to each of the APIs. And you can check the progress of the deployment by clicking on this Check Deployment button, and it will drop you into CloudFormations, and you can watch that in progress. But if I jump back to Amazon Verified Permissions for a second, and let's go take a look at the schema and the policies that we've created. So I click on Go to Overview. First, let's take a look at the schemas. We look at the schema represented in visual mode. You see we have an action diagram. And within that action diagram, we can see four actions that we've created, which map to the four API calls in our Pet Store API. We've also created an entity type called user for the users who will act as principals, and an entity type called application for an entity application on which these actions will occur. We click on the entity types diagram, you can see an additional entity type that we've created called user group, which users can be a member of. And of course, we have two user groups, customers and employees. Now let's take a look at the policies we've created. We have two policies, as we expected. The first is a policy for the employees, and it says that any principal or user within the group employees may take all of these actions, get pets on a particular pet ID, and post pets on a resource. And if we contrast that to the policy that we created for customers, we can see that users in the user group customers only get to call the get pets action. Now, let's go back, take a look at where we are with our deployment. You can see now that the Lambda authorizer that we created has been deployed to API Gateway, and we'll need to go across into API Gateway now and attach that Lambda authorizer to each of our APIs. Here we are back in API Gateway, and I'm going to backtrack to our Pet Store API. And as I said, I'm going to attach my newly created Lambda authorizer to each of the APIs. So let's start with the GET at the application level. And then the GET pets. And post pets. And lastly, the get at the level of an individual pet. And having done that, I'm going to redeploy my API to my pet store dev stage. We're now ready to start testing. And to test my integration, rather than creating a pet store application, I'm going to use Postman to simulate API requests submitted by the application against API Gateway. So the first thing my simulated application is going to need to do is to call Amazon Cognito to get an access token for one of my users. To simulate that, I create an HTTP request within Postman to post request. The URL that I use, I can grab from my Cognito user pool. Let me show you where that is. So if I'm in my Cognito user pool, Pet Store Users, I grab the URL and I just go as far as the, in this case, GKT, just before the backslash. So that gives me my Pet Store URL. And then on the authorization, I select no auth. In the headers, I put these three attributes in the headers, accept content type X Amazon target with these values. And then in the body, I put this auth workflow, blah, blah, blah. The client ID here, I'm pulling again from Cognito. And the way I get the client ID is I need to create an application integration client. I've already created one here called Pet Store App Login. Make sure that this client supports the authentication flow for user password auth. And my client ID will be here. So this is the client ID that I use within the string in Postman. And then my auth parameters are obviously the username, in this case, Julian, and Julian's password, somewhat unimaginatively, password 12256. So when I send that, that is going to Cognito, and Cognito is responding with an access token. And for ease of future reference, I'm going to grab that access token and copy it into Notepad. So Julian access token. Stop. And then I'm going to repeat that for Abby to get an access token for Abby by calling the same request with Abby's username and password. Okay, let's see if this works. Of course it's going to work. It's a pre-recorded demo, but still a little bit exciting. We're going to test now making an API call from the application simulated by Postman and see if our authorization rules are being applied correctly. So to do that, back in my Pet Store API, go to stages and scroll down, and I can pick the URL of the API I want to test. So let's start with the get pets. I can copy and paste the invoke URL, come across into Postman, enter that in. My authorization, I set to no auth because I'm doing authorization through the headers. And I put two values in the headers. First, authorization. And I set that to the, I said two values, I actually only put one value in. I set that to my access token. And I'm going to start by testing Abby. And remember, Abby is a customer. So we would expect Abby to be able to call the get pets API. But when we try in a moment, we would expect him not to be able to call, put in the wrong place, not to be able to call the post pets. So let's see if Abby can call get pets. And indeed he can. And we see returned a list of pets. Marvelous. Now let's see if Abby can call post pets. So let's change that to post and click on send. And indeed, Abby's not authorized to make that call. Now, if we contrast that with Julian, who is in the employee group, we would expect to be able to make both of our API calls. So let's go grab Julian's access token. And copy that in. And see first whether Julian can call get pets. You know, that's the easy one. And indeed he can. And now can Julian call post pets? And indeed he can. So Julian, who is an employee, is able to call both of these APIs. Okay, that's everything for this video. Thank you for sticking with us. I hope you found the content instructive. In future videos, we'll be taking a look at how you can amend your policies to include attribute-based conditions. But for the time being, here are some links to some additional information, including a link to the product page on our website, some recordings of presentations that we've done at conferences, and further information on the open source CEDAR language. Until next time, thanks. Bye.